If you've built apps in Angular in the past, I'm sure you've experienced the blank screen while you wait for the app to be bootstrapped. In smaller applications, it's not as noticeable, but in larger, more complex applications, we may need to wait for a little bit before we see the actual content loaded. And staring at a blank screen while we wait is not ideal. Well, we can upgrade this experience by adding our own custom loading screen, and it's pretty easy to do, too. In this video, that's exactly what we're going to do. So, in order to work on our loading screen, we're going to need to be able to see it, right? We'll need to do something to make it visible and keep it that way. Well, I've found that the easiest way to do this is to simply comment out the Bootstrap application function. This is the function that basically creates the Angular application, so by removing it, the app component and everything within it shouldn't load. If we save, we can see the loading screen will remain visible now. So now we're ready to work on it. The concept for this loading screen is pretty basic. If we look at the markup in the index document, we can see that we have the app root element here, which is the root component for our app. And within it, there's the word loading. So what happens here is whatever content we place within the opening and closing tags of the app root element will be visible while the application is bootstrapped. Then, once it has been bootstrapped, the content will be replaced with the content from the app root component itself. So all we need to do is add some styles and markup here to make this look more in line with our branding and application overall. We'll go ahead and even include the styles for this loading page right here in an embedded style sheet too. Okay, I think that should be everything that we need, so let's save and see how it looks. And there it is, pretty cool, right? Much better than the old blank loading screen. Now we can go back and add our bootstrap function. But I'm also going to wrap it in a set timeout to delay it a little bit. Now, I wouldn't normally want to do this, but this demo app is really small and loads super fast, so I just need to slow it down a little bit so that we can actually see the loading screen before the app loads. Okay, now when we save, we can see the new loading screen for 3 seconds and then the app loads. And this is a little bit better than it was, but it feels a little abrupt when it switches between the two screens. I think we can make this feel a little better by adding an enter animation to ease the app content when it loads in. But before we do this, I just want to point out that I've created several videos and even a playlist all about the animation framework in Angular, so you should totally check them out too. If any of what you're about to see is unclear, hopefully those videos will help. Okay, back to this example. Let's add the animations array. Now we'll need to add a trigger with the trigger function. Let's call it enter. Next, we need a transition using the transition function. And we'll be transitioning the enter state of our content. Okay, now we can add the starting state of our enter animation with the style function. Let's start from an opacity of 0 and a scale of 0.7. And for the last piece, we'll animate to our final state with the animate function. Let's go with a duration of 400 milliseconds and an easing function of ease in. Then we just need to add the final style with another style function. It will animate to an opacity of 1 and a scale of 1, too. Okay, so that's the animation. Now we can add the trigger on this div that wraps the rest of the content in this component. So when that div enters, this animation will run. And that's it. So let's save and see how it looks now. Nice, that's a lot better. Now, we could probably keep going on this if we wanted, but I'll go ahead and stop here because I'm sure you get the idea by now. It's pretty easy to create a much more intriguing loading screen with very little effort, and now you know exactly how to do it. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you did, Check out my channel for more videos about various topics and features within Angular. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.